I have fallen down a rabbit hole which has revealed a major geologic problem. A viewer of mine was exploring a remote area on Google Earth when they spotted something peculiar.
So, as a result, they sent me this set of coordinates. These coordinates brought me to a remote and essentially uninhabited portion of Yukon just south of the Arctic Circle, specifically to an unnamed riverbed in the Ogilvie mountain range. Upon zooming in, I instantly recognized the problem. Oh boy, this pristine river in the literal middle of nowhere should not be colored orangish brown. I have seen this before, this is clearly acid mine drainage. I have even seen this in Arizona, albeit on a much smaller scale at a Superfund site. So, I asked around with what website in the Yukon I should report this to, since it was unfamiliar due to Yukon only having a population of about 46,000 people. But before I did this, I realized that the problem was much, much worse. You see, I could find absolutely zero evidence that this very spot was ever the site of a mining claim or mine, an illegal dump, or an illegal mine. In fact, I could find zero evidence that this very spot had ever seen a human set foot here with mining equipment, meaning that this is not acid mine drainage, but instead something else. As, by looking around nearby, I can find five other drainages, streams, and riverbeds where the same process is also occurring. And it is not exclusive to this mountain range either. The same process is also seemingly occurring at streams in Canada's Northwest Territories and at more than five dozen streams in Alaska's Brooks Range. And while I could not detect the same process to be occurring in any of the countries listed here, the conditions are ripe in those countries for the same process occurring further down the line. These rivers which have turned orange have become acidic, some highly acidic, with a pH as low as 2.6. Additionally, many of these streams now have elevated levels of lead, arsenic, cadmium, cobalt, copper, and zinc, along with downright toxic levels of nickel, aluminum, manganese, and iron. It should not come as a surprise that wherever these orange rivers appear, fish species decline or disappear. So, why are some of the planet's most pristine waterways suddenly becoming toxic and unsafe to drink? The answer relates to the thawing of permafrost due to ongoing climate change which has raised world temperatures. For reference, permafrost is a layer of ground that remains completely at a temperature lower than that of the freezing point of water for two or more years straight. Some patches of permafrost are as much as 700,000 years old, while the vast majority of the world's current permafrost is many tens of thousands of years old. Permafrost currently underlies 18 million square kilometers, or 12% of Earth's landmass. Permafrost is an impermeable layer, meaning that groundwater cannot penetrate it while it exists. However, as worldwide temperatures rise, which is occurring nearly four times faster in the Arctic than the rest of the planet, this permafrost layer has shrunk. This has allowed two things to occur. First, large quantities of iron which were previously bound in a layer of permafrost became exposed to groundwater, allowing for it to become clustered together in higher concentrations where the groundwater flows. This allowed for large quantities of iron-reducing and cold-resistant bacteria to feed off of remains of previously frozen plant and animal remains, reducing the abundant iron-3 ions to iron-2 ions. The iron-2 ions then combine with oxygen to create a range of oxidized rust-colored compounds which groundwater seeps then bring to the surface and into rivers, turning them orange and brown. However, many of these permafrost regions also contain abundant mineral reserves, with one reasonably common deposit consisting of numerous sulfide minerals, one of which is pyrite. If pyrite is exposed to rainwater, it will react and turn the rainwater acidic. Since patches of pyrite and sulfide minerals previously trapped in permafrost are finding themselves now in the active layer, they are also being exposed to water for the first time in tens of thousands, sometimes hundreds of thousands of years. As a result, natural acid mine drainage occurs, and since pyrite often contains elevated levels of nickel, it carries large amounts of it and iron into regional streams. However, due to the increased acidity of the water caused by the pyrite runoff, other minerals that contain potentially harmful compounds become easier to erode, adding other elements to the water. And this is why many streams in remote Alaska and Canada are turning orange. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, EB, for supporting my work.